It's a beautiful evening again in the park, and we got a lot of excitement for you tonight, so we're going to get this going. Would you please put your hands together and welcome our director for this evening, Mr. Brett Fulman.
Thank you. Good evening. Now, if you are able, please rise as we have the presentation of the colors by the Piqua Central Intermediate School Young Leadership Group, coming in over on this side and coming up onto our stage.
He created the modern marching band, made them march in step, actually move, which was new to the Piqua Band at that time. He also created the boys' chorus, and of course, he organized and was the first director of the Elks Band, the Civic Band. Actually, we do have that one of the members here, Paul Holzinger. Paul, where are we? There's Paul. Paul actually played under Mr. Gates's director, as a director. Gates also produced the alma mater and the pep song. So one of the great musicians of the community of Piqua. Now I'd like to introduce the next piece, Light Cavalry. It may be the most performed overture by the band. It's very popular with audiences, written by Franz Sloopy in 1868 for his opera of the same name. Mr. Hance used to say that the overture is very popular today, even though no one has the slightest clue what the opera is about anymore. So, without further ado, the Light Cavalry.
Thank you.
of my familiarity with Light Cavalry came from the background music of Saturday morning cartoons. So that's probably where you're recognizing. Our next piece, Song of the Bells, was a waltz written in 1953 for the Boston Pops by Leroy Anderson, a very, very prolific composer. And we're going to see you hear several of his pieces. And in Piqua, for the last 40 or 50 years, it has been one of the most popular songs by the band. Ladies and gentlemen, Song of the Bells.
Favorite pieces, or this is the best piece.
I think you probably already know that because they usually don't play the things that nobody likes. And I did neglect to say, Paul played under Phil Gates. He also, little known fact, he also played under Bach. Our next local musicians, the Mills Brothers. Started out as four boys and a guitar, John Jr., Herbert, Harry, and Donald. Their big break was with Piqua's Harold Greenemeyer Orchestra. They played as teenagers on Cincinnati radio in 1927. Their first record was also in 27. Their first big hit was Tiger Rag in 1929. With the death of John Jr. in 1936, Father John Sr. stepped in. They played around the nation and around the world, particularly in Europe, with their last big hit being Cab Driver in 1968. The last brother, Donald, died in 1999. His son, John, carries on the tradition. I'd like at this time to invite those who received the Mills Brothers Scholarship from the audience to stand. This is not an easy scholarship to win, so these are accomplished musicians. I'd like to welcome now Tyrone and Tori Ann Collier, who are going to be our soloists tonight for the song Paper Doll. Paper Doll was written by Johnny Black in 1915, but it did not become a hit until it was sung by the Mills Brothers in 1943, selling over 6 million records. It's a phenomenal number. Ladies and gentlemen, Paper Doll.
I'm going apart.
who probably is new and strange to all of you, Bob Hance. Robert M. Hance Jr. was born near Piqua, PHS graduate during World War II. He was the band director at Fort Knox, and he wrote a piece and dedicated it to the commanding general of Fort Knox. There's a word for that, but we won't talk about that. Back to Piqua. Bob went to work for the city, became the youngest city manager in the state of Ohio from 1949 to 1972, and at the end of his term as city manager, he had the longest run of any city manager in the state of Ohio. He served as the director of the Civic Band for over 54 years. He was also a master cornet player, composer, and teacher. I had the honor of being one of Mr. Hance's cornet students, and after the third lesson, he turned to me and said, "Jim, stick to speaking." Now one of his pieces, The Old Pavilion. The Old Pavilion was written by Bob, but we're not quite sure the exact reason. Obviously, I think it has a lot to do with the pavilion here, which is now, of course, Hance Pavilion, built in the 1920s for Chautauqua, and, of course, the band's very long tenure here. Ladies and gentlemen, The Old Pavilion.
Evening. Miss Mary Alice Newmar, our vice president. We have a band manager. I'm not sure where he went. He's over here. There he is. Chris Mangus over there. Board members, Randy Heron in the trombone section. Jim Vetter over here on trumpet. And then Ron Curtis, who's running sound for us tonight. Let's give them a round of applause. I'd like to thank some of our sponsors. First of all, if you check out the list in your program, these are vital to our survival. People giving whatever they can, some as little as $25. We have a full concert sponsored this year in the Miami County Foundation for our Christmas concert, so they are going to sponsor that concert for us. If you have not joined us as a sponsor, we invite you to consider making a donation. We'll make sure we get you in the Christmas program. But if you see these people, thank them for supporting live music in our community, because without them, we would cease to exist up here. So thank you if you are a sponsor. Please thank those people as well. We'd also like to thank TV5, who's been recording for us all season, as well as WPTW, who let us air some promos throughout the season as well on their radio station. But most of all, we want to thank you, our audience. Thank you for coming out this summer and supporting us. We hope to see you guys again at Christmas and next summer as well. But there's one special person that I would like to recognize right now, and that is Mrs. Peg Hance. Peg, longtime wife of Bob, and even after his death, has continued to support the band. She's let us use the Hance Library, and she did something this year that I am very glad. She's the one who decided to go ahead and donate the Hance Library to the Piqua Library, thus keeping probably the largest and most intact historical collection of music in the state of Ohio in our town for the use of this band and other bands in the area. And Peg, I really appreciate that. Thank you for doing that. Over the course of the years, we've had a large number of great musicians on the stage, and every year we unfortunately lose a few. We lost two this year. In the clarinet section, we had a member, Bill Gunder, who passed away, and help me out, was he 86 years old, played in the band for a long time. And the other one was Dan Arismith, who was quite younger, who played in our saxophone section. And both of them passed away in this last year. So for all those great musicians who have left us and for the two of them, we're going to end our first half with Irish tune from County Derry, better known as Danny Boy.
Thank you.
OH!
Good to see you guys.
Thank you.
Our next piece is a favorite of mine, Buglers Holiday. Another Leroy Anderson piece written in 1954 for the Boston Pops. It's probably one of the most popular trumpet trio pieces for orchestra and bands. And personally, when they played this in the late 60s, early 70s, they were a little short of cornets, and so Mr. Hance asked me to play with the band. I was so overwhelmed, and I must have done really well because he never asked me to play again. Ladies and gentlemen, Buglers Holiday.
This year, we were so glad to bring back our student mentoring program, sponsored by a generous grant from the Piqua Community Foundation. And we had one student who's played all season with us. He is currently going into his senior year at Troy High School. And when he picks a college and gets accepted, he will receive a scholarship from this band, thanks to that grant from the foundation. But in the meantime, I would like to call him up and recognize him. We have a plaque we'd like to present to him this evening. Mr. Brett Gailey, back in the trombone section. Students like this that are the future of this band. And talking about great musicians at Piqua, I'm very glad to see what's going on with the high school music programs. Mr. Westfall does a fantastic job with the choirs. And this year, for the first time in 20-some years, the marching band and the concert band both went to state at Piqua High School. So that's a great thing. Now it's audience participation time, so if you take a look at your programs, you'll find a set of words. Now, this march is familiar to pretty much anybody who's ever come to one of our concerts before. What may not be familiar are the words. If you look at the set of your program, it says, on them all. These words were not written by anybody just at random. They were written by the composer's wife. She decided that she was going to write some words to this song. So this is the tune that goes, la, 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 la. But we're going to sing it with the words. The band, if you guys are going to kind of help me out here. Okay, let's have a little choir practice before we sing this with the march. So the way this works is in the trio of the march, I'll cue you. That's when you start singing the words the first time. The second time, you whistle if you can. If you can't, just go. I can't whistle, okay? So here we go. On a peaceful summer evening when the sun has set and the cares of the day linger yet, don't be sad and don't be tired, there's a place to go where there's rest brought by sweet music's flow. Neath the trees with shadows dark, the starry sky above, there is calm, there is peace, there is love. There's forgetting care and trouble, all may claim a share of joy, hope, and courage rare. Easy peasy, right? All right, let's hear you nice and loud when we get to the trio. I'll cue you.
Thank you.
two items first. So that's what Buglers Holiday is supposed to sound like? I know why you didn't ask me back. And when the Civic Band was singing during On the Mall, we are truly, truly blessed that they're a band and not a chorus. Our next song is going to be Pop's Polka, written by Jack Mason and Arthur Fiedler, who is a longtime conductor of the Boston Pops, written in 1955. Ladies and gentlemen, Pop's Polka.
This is the 20th anniversary of Music Warehouse. It's going to be here in a couple of weeks. It's a fantastic production. Many of our members of the band up here play a hit for it, and Tom always does a fantastic job with it. So if you get a chance, it's free. Come out and enjoy the performances here at Hance Pavilion. So with no further ado, Mr. Tom Westphal.
Thank you.
Well, how about ending with The Music Man? Opened on Broadway in 1957, written by Meredith Wilson, who, by the way, had been a piccolo player in Sousa's band, which is a fascinating tidbit. It's a very nostalgic look at life in Wilson's hometown of Mason City, Iowa, the turn of the 20th century. The songs in this arrangement are familiar to everyone. 76 trombones. The wide trombones should have, you know, anything about them. I don't know. Maybe clarinet players, you know. Till There Was You. The Wells Fargo Wagon, Light a Rose, and my personal favorite, Marion the Librarian. Selections from The Music Man.
Thank you.
Thank you again. You've been a wonderful audience this summer. We thank you for coming out. Just remember, we are doing a Christmas concert again this year. We'll be at Westminster Presbyterian in downtown Piqua. That's on Sunday, December 6th at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. We hope you can all come out and join us Sunday, December 6th, again at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Thanks again. Here is our national march, the Stars and Stripes Forever. Thank you.